Hi everyone, this is Evita, and on today's episode of New Earth Living, we are going to be covering the topic of honoring our journeys. So first off, what does honoring our journeys mean? What is a journey? Is perhaps the first question that we should begin with. Well, the journeys that we're going to be talking about today could be both physical, mental, emotional, or spiritual. Every single one of us has different needs in our life and goes through various phases and changes along our personal life paths. Sometimes we are called to go on a journey that is physical. Perhaps we are being called to visit another country or move to another location, change where we live, etc. At other times, we are called on various mental, emotional, spiritual journeys, perhaps to go within and examine our internal environment. What are the emotions that we are feeling, sharing with others on a regular basis? What are the thoughts that we are experiencing ourselves within our own mind? What kind of self-talk do we have? So all of these could be different aspects of journeys. And of course, a spiritual journey can include anything from a formal retreat to a personal meditation at any time. Some journeys can be short, other journeys can be long, and some journeys, of course, as our life journey, can last an entire lifetime. So why I thought it would be a really valuable idea to talk about the aspect of honoring our journeys is really for two main reasons. One, which we'll talk about first, is that today, I believe more than ever, a lot of us are being called to go on certain personal journeys. And two, is to share with you a personal journey that I'm actually going to embark on that is going to be a big sort of first in my own life. So let's talk about the first reason. As we are at a time that I believe for myself, from personal experience and also from hearing from so many other people, is a type of awakening, is a shift on our planet, in our energies, both personally and collectively. Many people are feeling these changes and being called to journey. Now, journey where? For some, it's within. For others, it's to new locations. It might mean changing a job. It might mean changing a home. It might mean visiting that place that's been always in the back of your mind, that's been calling you to go there. So physical journeys could entail all sorts of changes in location, whereas internal, mental, spiritual, emotional journeys could entail perhaps going on a retreat, taking up meditation. Maybe you're a very lively person and you feel like pulling back. Maybe you're a very shy person and you feel like taking a different type of approach as you journey through life and becoming more open to interacting with many other individuals. No matter what the journey is, I think the most important thing at the end of the day is that we honor our personal journey. Sometimes, and actually all too often, we don't listen to what our inner being is asking us for. We suppress, we repress, we deny what we are being called to do from within our heart and soul. And this perhaps is one of the worst things we can do for ourselves because we cause ourselves unnecessary suffering. We think that if we take a certain step, go on a certain journey again, whether it's spiritual, mental, emotional, within, or physical, somewhere externally outside of ourselves, we think that this might cause a lot of havoc in our life or maybe cause too much change. But in actuality, our inner being will let us know that we need to go do that certain thing. We need to go and journey to that certain place. Maybe pull back, maybe go out of our way to experience something new. And when we don't honor that, our body, physically, mentally, emotionally, does speak to us in ways that make us know that something's not quite right in our life. And so in honoring our journeys, I invite you to look within. What is your inner being calling you to do today? Maybe it's to start a new site, a blog of some sort, where you can express your thoughts about a topic that you are really, really passionate about, or perhaps a topic that has a lot of personal importance to you. Perhaps you are being called within to change your circle of friends. Honor that journey. Perhaps you are being called to a new lifestyle change, a new diet change. Honor that journey. Perhaps you are being called to re-examine your spiritual belief system. Maybe adopt a new one, maybe leave an old one. Honor that journey. Listen to your inner being. What is your heart and soul asking of you right now? When it comes to physical journeys, whether it's a change in a job, a change in a home location, or visiting a new area, again, these can be scary. We can get caught up in details thinking, how am I going to have the money to do this? And all sorts of things. And what effect will this have perhaps on my personal relationships? But again, when we don't listen to our inner being, all sorts of things will manifest in our life that make life feel like a struggle, like a challenge, and there's suffering involved. When we honor our journeys, things fall into place. We may not always believe it or see it right away, but they always do. One other aspect that is very important in this discussion is not only to honor our own journey, but to honor the journey of others. Your partner, your spouse right now, might be going through some major changes, again, spiritually, emotionally, physically. We tend to take personally what another person does, especially when they're close to us, our child, our spouse, our parent, etc., and feel like our identity is attached to what they do or don't do. This is a great time to reflect on that and find your own space in that as you honor your own journey, honor the other person's journey as well. Like yourself, many people are being called to experience new and different realms of this life experience. Many people are being called to, again, perhaps re-examine their thoughts, their beliefs, maybe change everything in their life. Yes, it's hard for us if we are attached to that person or live with that person. However, we have to know that every single person must honor their journey. And in turn, it helps them honor their journey when we also honor ours. And so the second reason that I wanted to share with you this theme today is that in my own personal life, I try to always stay very in tune with what my inner being is asking at any given time. As this new year 2012, full of amazing vibrational energies, has started, my journey that I was being called on within was to create from a new space. Yet within a few months, I noticed that the energies within me were shifting and a new perspective was being formed. One that asked me actually to pull back, go within, focus on where is it that my next steps will take me. And so my next journey is actually going to be something that I've never experienced in my life before, and that is going on a long distance hike. So the journey that I'm honoring in myself is a physical one at this time and also a spiritual one. On the journey, I will be hiking long distance, over about 600 kilometers, which again is a wonderful first. And I don't know what this journey will entail, but I know I'm going to honor my journey and go ahead and take the first step. And in the end, this is all that we can do. Listen to our inner being, take the first step, and allow the universe to guide us on the second step. When we honor our journeys, we allow ourselves to expand through our consciousness and allow ourselves also to open our heart, trust, have courage, ignite our strength, and experience more facets of this amazing diversity of life. And so if you are watching this around the time of spring 2012, and if you are a regular subscriber to either evolvingbeings.com or on YouTube, I will be taking a break from creating regular material as I honor this journey within and step back for about a month and a half to reflect within, honor my own journey, and allow my inner being to speak to me as to where my next steps along my personal life path may lay. And so I hope that you do listen to your inner being, honor the journeys that may be birthing within you, or perhaps you're already well along your new journey that you've been called to. May you continue to find the strength, courage, perseverance, and inspiration to honor your journey and at the same time honor the journeys of others. Whatever they may be, may we support each other along this beautiful life path rather than cause resistive forces. Wishing you all a wonderful spring and summer of 2012.